Well, MRD means minimal residual disease. So it means trying to understand when there is no more myeloma in the body of the patient. And it is meaningful because we showed in several studies showed that those patients who get into minimal residual disease, so those patients where we cannot find myeloma cells in the body with a specific after a specific level that we call sensitivity, those patients are the patients who have the better survival and the better duration of remission after treatment. We have presented two types of data related to MRD in this meeting. One is an analysis of correlation between two different techniques that evaluates how to detect if a patient has or not minimal residual disease. These two techniques are called flow cytometry and next generation sequencing. They are different, but they have a good concordance. So it is important for patients because it means that these are two different technologies that can be applied and can be used to the centers to be informative for the patients also. And we are presenting other data where we evaluate if MRD has a role in predicting the outcome of patients in terms of what we call early relapse. So we know that some patients respond well to treatment, but despite the response, the disease reappears early. And we want to understand why this happens and what are the factors that can increase or reduce the risk of this reoccurrence of the disease. And we saw that those patients who get MRD negativity have a lower risk of relapsing early to treatment. So this is informative because you know that then you have to pursue MRD negativity. A surrogate endpoint is an endpoint that is predictive of another outcome. And there is a big effort from the scientific community to show, to demonstrate if MRD is a surrogate endpoint. So far, we cannot say that yet. We are working on it to try to demonstrate it. Well, the first question is if it is really a surrogate endpoint, if it can be applied to different settings of the disease, for example, newly diagnosed, for example, relapse, elderly, young. It looks like it has the same impact in different settings. And then one of the questions is what is the role in patients with high-risk disease? We know that it works, it improves the outcome. We are still working to try to define very well what is this impact. Well, there is the international community that is working. There are definitions of MRD negativity by the International Myeloma Working Group. And there is a big team that is called I2 team that is gathering the data of more than 4,000 patients enrolled in clinical study to show to look at MRD and to see if MRD can be used as a surrogate endpoint for treatment decisions, for drug approval and drug availability.